Burke? You with me, Mr. Burke?
Yeah, sorry.
I know it's late, but I need you to confirm some details from your file, if you'd just take a look.
That's me, all right. That from a month ago?
That photo's from last July.
Right. Forgot about July. Not exactly a spotless record.
No, we all make mistakes when we're young. I don't have a permanent address for you?
That's right.
I see. Mr. Burke, I'd like to get your statement on record.
Statement?
About the house on Sansome Way. What you were doing there, the state we found you in.
Okay. Sure.
This is Sheriff's Detective Nina Mercy, 3:43 a.m., interviewing Emmanuel Burke about...
You won't believe me, though.
That depends on you. Whenever you're ready.
Well, as you know, Aunt Faye has been missing for weeks, and I've been worried about her, as anybody. So I went to her place to see if I could figure out where she'd gone, because people don't just up and vanish.
Hello?
The hell? Thank you. Take that, thank you. What possible reason could someone have for this?
Okay, I've got to interrupt you. What do you mean a figure in the shower? You mean you saw a person?
I think I did, yeah.
Because we didn't see any sign of someone else in the house with you.
They disappeared as soon as I saw them.
You mean they got away? Like, out a window or something?
Yeah, or something. Thank you. come in handy.
Thank you.
It's open, thank God.
I'm afraid you were right, Mr. Burke.
How's that, Detective?
I don't believe one word you've said.
Honestly, that's all the same to me. Because this story is just getting started.
Ready to continue, Mr. Burke?
Sure, Detective. Whatever you say.
So, to summarize, Mr. Burke, the note you discovered upstairs suggested Aunt Faye had gone to hide some of her possessions, from whom you do not know.
Right. And I'm thinking, if I retrace her steps, maybe I'll find Aunt Faye, too.
And how'd you manage to get those bruises?
Well, the whole time I'm up there, I got this feeling there's somebody watching me. When I get the door unlocked to let myself out, I hear, like, a giggle. I turn around, and she's right there. And I freak and fall down the damn stairs.
So, you'd like to revise your account?
I just want to be clear. I thought I saw someone at the time. Obviously, it was just a shadow. A trick of the light.
A trick of the light that sent you tumbling down the stairs. And after sustaining a concussion, the details from here forward are inconveniently fuzzy.
Yeah, it really was a hell of a fall. God damn, that hurts.
I gotta stop you again, Burke.
Come on, Detective. You keep interrupting me. This is gonna take all night.
Then let's save some time. We found these items just outside the house, not 10 yards from where we picked you up. Any idea how they came to be there? Before you answer, remember, we have your fingerprints on file.
Look, I can explain those.
Oh, yeah? Let me guess. You needed the sterling candelabra to light your way? The gold necklace held the key to Aunt Faye's whereabouts? Come on, drop the Good Samaritan act. You're a crook.
I...
You heard Miss Van Weeren had disappeared and thought, she's got no family. Nobody will mind if a few things go missing. True or false?
True.
Finally, we get somewhere.
True, that's why I went in there. But that's not why I stayed.
Burke, I've got you admitting to breaking and entering. If you think you're going to talk your way out of this...
I'm not. Just, would you let me finish my story, Detective?
Okay. Let's hear it. But here on out, no more bullshit.
The hell? Where'd my key ring get to? Shit. They'll be able to hear that from the street.
And? Then what? Burke, stop saying what you think I want to hear. Tell me what you saw.
Do you know about Aunt Faye's dolls?
Dolls? What, she's got some kind of collection? Burke, tell me what you saw.
Aunt Faye definitely been through there. She left a note. And a can of gasoline.
Gasoline? Is that all? Burke?
Weren't you listening the first 50 times I told you?
Don't worry, we have it all on tape.
Yep, and I already admitted to robbing the place, but then I just wanted to get out.
So why didn't you?
Because the house had other plans. Caved in behind me. Must have been a goddamn earthquake.
Not in my county. You want to try again?
What do you want to know?
How about explaining the gas can we found in the library?
Must have been Aunt Faye's. She had a lot to burn. Bridges, bad memories, sins.
I want to believe your story, Mr. Burke, but it's starting to sound more like a fairy tale.
Unfortunate choice of words. Welcome. Diary indeed. Dear Diary. Oh, dear. I'm gonna be locked in the ultimate responsibility room if I'm not out of here before the cops show up.
Thank you.
Most little girls write about boys and candy. Guess young Aunt Faye wasn't like most little girls. What the- That ugly candle holder nearly killed me. If I wanted to save my neck, I had to find the responsibility room.
Well, that word sounds funny coming out of your mouth.
There's nothing funny about it. When she was a little girl, Faye did a horrible thing, but her punishment was even worse. Her father locked her up in the dark and just forgot about her for days. She finally found a way out, so I needed to follow her footsteps.
I'll bite. So, how did you break into the so-called responsibility room?
By playing along with a dead girl's game. What are the chances this piece of crap actually works? I've never been so happy to hear a dial tone in my life.
911, what's your emergency?
You gotta send someone out to the Willahauk mansion. Now. I'm trapped inside.
Trapped? Are you hurt?
Just my pride. Listen, I don't have time to explain all the crazy stuff going down in here. Either send a cop or a hearse. Just hurry.
You're not making any sense. Please calm down.
I can't calm down. This house is gonna kill me. Hello? See? I'm cooperating. I even called 911 from the house phone.
You mean this house phone?
Why do you have that?
It's evidence. Covered with your fingerprints, sweat, and tears. Problem is, it hasn't been connected for years.
That's impossible. You must have a recording of the 911 call, right?
Right.
911, what's your emergency?
This is Faye Van Winnen at 11 Sansome Way. My history is finally catching up to me. I'm trapped.
Trapped? Are you hurt?
Oh, yes. I was bad, and I needed to be punished. But now I've had enough, and I want to get out.
You're not making any sense. Please calm down.
I can't calm down. The dolls are going to kill me.
It can't be. Her? Thank you.
what you wanted, even if it killed you.
Here, hurry! I surrender. Arrest me. I don't care. Just start the car. So, yes. Aunt Faye is dead. She was dead when I got there, and she was dead when I left. But I didn't touch her. Just ask your cops.
If you're not gonna tell the truth, I can't help you.
What do you mean? I told you everything.
And your story has no basis in reality. My officers found no body, no blood, and no Faye Van Weren.
You're lying! What are you writing?
Just making my final notes. I'm done with you. Great. Just what I need.
Wait! You can't leave me here in the dark.
Happy?
Happy? Far from it. So, what did the good detective scribble in her Manila manifesto? She wouldn't have left it here if she didn't want me to read it.
This is Sheriff's Detective Nina Mercy, 10:15 a.m. The longest day of my life is finally over. I drove out to the estate and verified what the officers told me. No sign of Miss Van Weren. Then when I got back to the station, our main suspect was gone too. Two missing persons, zero leads. Not a great day for law enforcement. I put out an APB for Emmanuel Burke. Wanted for breaking and entering, robbery, possible kidnapping, and now escape. Weirdest thing, though. He left a generous blood sample back at the station. It had to be Burke's. Matched his DNA on file. But it wasn't just blood. It was all mixed up with what looked like pixie dust. Where'd you fly off to, Mr. Burke?